So good morning to our Prasanth here. So I'll be handling welding technology subject for you students, and today we'll be seeing about introduction plus about welding process. And first unit we'll be seeing gas welding, arc welding. Since name itself implies it is a gas welding, we'll be using some gases for heating the workpiece for joining. And the gases mostly used will be the acetylene gas, acetylene and oxygen will be used. So depending upon the heat energy we required, we'll be changing the proportion of the acetylene as well as oxygen. Suppose if you are giving more oxygen and acetylene, the flame will be called as oxidizing flame. So if you are giving more acetylene gas and less oxygen, and we'll be calling it as a carburizing flame. So if you are giving equal amount of acetylene plus equal amount of oxygen, we'll be calling it as a neutral flame. So if you see oxidizing flame, since oxygen is oxygen content, we are giving more amount, we'll be getting more heat energy out of oxidizing flame. Since if you see second case in carburizing flame, since we are giving more amount of acetylene gas, we'll be getting less heat energy. So in neutral flame, when we compare to both the cases, the temperature will be lesser. So you might ask the question, why we are giving these many conditions. Suppose if we need a melting point of the metal is higher than certain degree, for example 1000 degree, 2000 degree, we'll be going for oxidizing flame. Suppose if we need to melt aluminium, for an aluminium we know that melting temperature is lower, we'll be going for carburizing flame or else neutral flame. So next we'll see about arc welding. So if you take arc welding, the name itself implies it is an arc. So we'll be producing some electric spark for heating the workpiece. So arc welding is subdivided into many types. If you see, carbon arc welding,